of the blog Life as a Rambling Redhead. I am ready to start week two of my healthy lunchbox series, What's Packin'? If you guys missed the first episode of What's Packin', make sure you go back and watch the first one so you're not missing out on any good ideas. I'm gonna put the link in the video description below. I'm also gonna put some affiliate links of all the things I'm showing you in the video for quick and easy shopping. Real quick before we jump on in, make sure you go ahead and push that subscribe button, the little red button, as well as the bell icon so you get notified whenever I make new videos. Now let's stop talking and jump on into some lunches. It's Monday morning. Gonna go ahead and dive into it. So I got these croissants at Costco in bulk, obviously. First time to shop at Costco. And I thought they were something new rather than his normal oat nut bread. So here we have ham, cheese, and spinach sandwiches. And I put these little pit guys in here just so he can kind of eat with it without it falling apart. Then we have some veggie straws. Over here, like I got a huge sack of organic veggie straws, basically serve in place of chips, because that's what they are. They're still chips. We've got some strawberries and some cantaloupe with our little cow pig guy. We've got some broccoli that I just tossed in some olive oil with some salt and pepper. If your kids don't like vegetables, try different seasonings. I found that that works really well, at least for my kids. And then here we have a little container of Trader Joe's dried blueberries. He really likes those. They're a little sour for my two-year-old, but he likes them. And then here for his little sweet treat, he has a little energy bar. I got these at Costco in bulk as well. There's just these little sunrise energy bars. They have rolled oats, dried cranberries, sunflower seeds, flax seeds, quinoa, coconut, pumpkin seeds, chia seeds, and cashews, and more. And these are really, really good. In fact, this week Vaughn is in charge of snacks for his class, and this morning they're getting a full one of these bars and half an apple sliced up. So my kids love them. We actually call them oatmeal cookies. Along with his lunchbox, I'm also giving him one of these Plum Organics veggie pouches. This is sweet potato, apple, and corn. And then I've got sister's lunch packed up, and she gets the exact same thing. Time for the reveal. Let's open her up. Hey, he didn't do that bad. I say that way because in the car he told me that he wasn't that hungry for lunch. So this is way better than I expected it to be. I see he did not like this pouch. The majority of it is still in there. This is a new flavor for us, and he did tell me that he wanted the green pouch, which I'm totally fine with, only getting him spinach and pea pouches. I feel like that's a win. All right, we got all of our picks back. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really surprised that all the fruit is there. That is super weird. So he ate all of his croissant sandwich, he ate all of his veggie straws, he ate a lot of his broccoli. I gave him a ton of broccoli. You can't see how deep this thing is, but I gave him a lot of broccoli. And he ate his little energy bar. So definitely not as much as he normally eats. Weird that the fruit's still there, but since the fruit is there, that shows me that he wasn't lying. He truly wasn't that hungry. I did ask Vaughn if he liked the croissant, ham, cheese, and spinach sandwich, and he said he loved it so much and he requested another one for snack. So we've never done the croissants before. So maybe if your kids don't like sandwiches, it's the type of bread you're getting. Maybe you try a croissant. I've done regular oat nut bread. I've done the bagel thins. I've never done the croissants before, but I did it this time because I got them bulk at Costco and they were a really big hit. So maybe try that. She ate half of her sandwich. She ate a lot of broccoli, actually. She ate all of her veggie straws. Again, we have some regurgitated food. That is a trend with my daughter. And then she did eat all of her fruit. So she did pretty good. Everyone did all right today. Not the best day, but not the worst. It's Tuesday. Today the kids are home with me, as you can hear in the background. Sorry about that noise. And we are actually headed out in about 2 minutes here to a little outdoor museum close by to our house. It's our homeschool day, so we're gonna get out and do a little play date and learn some stuff, yay. We have little star hams and cheeses, and I even made the breads little stars so they can assemble a little sandwich like a Lunchable. This actually doesn't take too much time to stamp them out. The stamps are really simple, and I usually do it right after I go grocery shopping, and then I keep this all in the fridge like this so I can just throw it in. Simple, quick, and easy whenever I actually need it. We've got some grapes over here. We've got cucumber that they can just pick up and eat like a pickle. Sugar snap peas, you guys see these in my kids' lunch a lot simply because they like them as is. They don't even need dip for them, so it's a good win for me. Here we've got some leftover chips I'm trying to use up. These are sweet potato chips with nutmeg and cinnamon, and then these are those little ghost chips from Trader Joe's. And then their little sweet treat for today, if they eat all their food, is this gross looking thing. You can barely see it because it's so dark. It's just cherry, apple, and chia seeds. There's no sugar added, so I like it. There is a lot of sugar in it, just naturally from the fruit. It's basically the equivalent to a healthy fruit roll-up. Sister's lunch, of course, is exactly the same, just a little bit of less in quantity. So, while we were at the outdoor museum, we actually ate lunch outside on picnic tables with our friend. My kids were very distracted, and they definitely did not finish off their lunch. So after we got back from the museum, we sat down and we finished our lunches, and they were a little more focused on the meal. So Vaughn did good today. He ate all of his ham, his bread. Today was a day when he didn't like cheese, so he didn't eat the cheese. We've got our sugar snap peas here that he ate some whole, and then some of the other ones he just busted them apart and ate out the peas from the middle, which he learned from my two-year-old actually, who loves to do that. He ate all of his chips, which isn't shocking. And then he had, what else did he have over here? He had a cucumber, and then he had grapes, so he finished all that. And he did not like the sweet treat for today. It was a texture thing. These guys are kind of gummy and chewy and sticky and moist and he did not like it one bit. On the other hand, my daughter loved that little apple and chia bar. So we had sugar snap peas here and a cucumber. She has this little bit left of a cucumber. She said it was mushy, so it might have not been the best quality. Sugar snap peas, all of them are gone. I can see she ripped open the peas and we have a little bit regurgitated here because it's, I can tell there's strings. She cannot stand the strings. She finished all of her grapes. And she finished all of her sandwich completely. All the bread stars, ham, and cheese stars. So all in all, they did really good today. We just had to eat two times because they couldn't keep focused while with their friend at the outdoor museum. They had live dinosaurs set up and they were so stoked about all of those dinosaurs. Overall, I would say today was a mom win. Today for Vaughn's lunch, we have the old traditional lunchbox because today we are rocking the thermos. I filled this up with boiling water. I let it sit for 30 minutes just because that's how much time I had. The water still came out boiling when I dumped it 30 minutes later. We've got some chicken nuggets in there. I don't want to let all that hot air out. This is a sweet treat for today. It's just a banana and pumpkin plum organics pouch. In here we've got, I just got these from Target. We've got some sliced apple in here, and then I got these from Costco, and Vaughn loves them. And if you look at the ingredients, it is only avocados, tomatoes, red onions, onions, jalapeno pepper, cilantro, lime juice, sea salt, and garlic. That's it. So I love these. They're little pre-made guacamoles. I didn't want it to turn brown, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep the top on. And then these are little organic sea salt crackers, and we use them as chips. So he's gonna have some chicken, some guac, some apples, and then in here we just have his vegetables, which are some carrots and a little bit of just plain spinach, and he'll eat that plain like a little salad. If you're wondering what kind of chicken nuggets I use, I really like the Applegate Natural. Then for sister's lunch today, we have basically the same thing. We get the Annie's organic mac and cheese, and we might have this once a week on days when brother's not here because brother cannot stand mac and cheese. I mean, if he puts it in his mouth, he starts dry heaving to where he's gonna puke. So we do this on days that mama wants some pasta and Berkeley wants it too. Okay guys, so here's the part where you're actually not going to see how much Vaughn ate because mama got the flu this afternoon. I couldn't even stand to film the lunchbox, so many apologies, so sorry. I was in bed for over 24 hours away from my kids, which I know what you're thinking, sounds like heaven, but I was actually super bored. Anyways, I'm better now, except random times of the day I get cough attacks where I literally have to hawk up a lung until I gag and then the itch goes away. It's super fun. Fun times. Today we have our little sandwich sushi roll. It's got some peanut butter and agave in there. You can put anything you want in there. My kids like this and it's actually clean and quick. Because I only did one piece of bread per child, I also have two little peanut butter crackers I guess put some peanut butter by itself. You can use almond butter, whichever. I just use whatever I have on hand. These are some organic cucumbers with some salt on them, just a little bit of salt. And then these, have you ever heard of the Pirate's Booty? My kids love Pirate's Booty, like in place of chips. Not an everyday thing, but a good little snack. And then we've got some organic strawberries over here with a little pick so they can pick it up and eat it. And for their sweet treat, we've got some strawberry banana organic Greek yogurt. They can take their little energy bar and dip it in the yogurt and eat it. They have a couple little cubes of that. They can also take the strawberries and dip it in the yogurt, or I'm gonna pack them a spoon so they can just eat the yogurt by itself. We have a little Happy Babies pouch. It's apple, kale, and avocados. My daughter loves this and she uses this like applesauce. My four-year-old son does too. And then my daughter has the exact same lunch. I probably packed her too much because I packed the exact same amount as her four-year-old brother. So for a two-year-old, I bet she does not finish all of this. Time for the reveal. Vaughn did pretty good. He ate all but one of his little peanut butter agave sushi sandwiches. He ate all of the peanut butter and crackers. Ah, this one bite. He ate all of its Pirate's Booty, all of his strawberries. I got the little pick back. That's always good. He ate only two of his cucumber sticks, which isn't that great. And then something regurgitated. It looks like he ate his little oatmeal cookie energy bar and spit it out, changed his mind. Huge mom fail, forgot a spoon. So when you don't have a spoon, I guess you don't eat the yogurt. Berkeley did pretty good. She ate most of her cucumber. She did not eat the little energy bar cookies. She ate all of the sushi roll except one. She ate all the Pirate's Booty, all the strawberries, and she did have a spoon since she was at home with me. And they both ate a pouch on top of this. So overall today was a mom win. Today we're doing another thermos lunch. Vaughn was asking for one of those Applegate organic all beef hot dogs. So we're gonna cut two of those up to make four little pieces and put them in the thermos. Currently right now I have my boiling water sitting in here so it gets nice and warm to keep the hot dogs warm throughout the day. And then over here we've got our little mustard, and then I gave him a spoon if he wants to spoon out the mustard, because I'm not sure the hot dogs are gonna fit in there to dip, because I've given him, we don't have hot dog buns. I hardly ever have hot dog buns unless I'm buying for like a cookout. So I gave him this oat nut bread, and he can take the little hot dog, wrap it up, and I don't think that he's gonna be able to dip with that. So that's why I've got the spoon to spoon out the mustard for him. I got two little pieces of bread because I think that's all he'll do. And then we've got his carrots over here, sliced carrots. We got little organic Annie's cheddar bunnies. Now I do not put, they're just these little bags that I got at Costco, these little individual size, but even then I don't put the whole bag in here just because I know what's gonna happen. He's gonna fill up on these and then he's not gonna eat anything else. Let's be real. So just half a bag is, I think, a plenty amount for a little side cracker. And then we have our little grapes cut up with our little poker guy. And then over here for the dessert or sweet treat, we have dried fruit. So we have some organic dried apples and dried bananas that I just get at Trader Joe's. These are very sweet, making the perfect snack. And then today he has soccer, so we're adding a little bit more with our plum organics pear, spinach, and pea pouch. Something fun we started this week is called mystery question. So I tape a little question on his lunchbox, and then during nap time, they don't really nap anymore. They as in the class as a whole. So his teacher is really good about letting Vaughn bring his own books into the classroom since he does already know how to read, and he kind of does his own thing during reading time and nap time. So today he's bringing his president's book, and then that's why I have a question about the presidents. And so he can go at nap time, look up the answer, and then whenever he gets home I say, what's the answer to the mystery question? And then he gets all excited about that. I think I've mentioned this before in a previous week one lunch video, but I love these silicone baking molds. These are just little heart cupcake. They look kind of weird from the dishwasher, but anyways, I just stick these in here because they kind of move with the food, so I can jam more in here, but it keeps everything separated and dry, and then you have more of a little bit than like this whole square of being one thing, because My kids, and especially my four-year-old, love a little bit of a lot more stuff. And if you're finding that your kid is bored with eating and they're not eating a ton at one sitting, try like buffet style, which is a little bit of a lot of things. I don't use this mentality during dinner. I don't do a smorgasbord of things because I don't have time for that. But with lunches, it's a little bit different since everything's pretty easy. Some of it's pre-made, or it's just chopping up fruit or veggies. So I do a little bit of a lot of stuff, and I find that really successful with my kids. I think it just keeps their interest, and they don't get bored, and they don't do five bites of one thing and then they're done. They can do five bites of like five different things versus two. And then for sister's lunch today, we basically have the same thing. I've noticed that my two-year-old takes forever, I mean eternity, to finish one stinking carrot. So if, and then usually she spits it out because she gets sick of chewing on it. So I've noticed that if I cut them right down the middle in half, she eats them normal, she doesn't spit them back up, and it's a little bit faster and easier for her to chew. And then over here we are out of the little hot dogs since brother finished off the pack. So we have some little organic turkey rolls and some cheese. I normally would wrap them both together, but since brother hates cheese, I think she's hearing him protest cheese, so now she thinks something's wrong with it. So now she's a hit or miss, and she was my cheese lover. I don't understand these children. Reveal time. Oh, you did pretty good on the hot dogs. Just a half of one left. Let's see. He did get into the mustard. He did not use the spoon, so I won't be sending one back. He ate all of the apples and only a few of the dried bananas. Not mad about that either. Let's see. What a mess. Okay, so he ate almost all of his carrots. A little bit, I'm telling you, that was plenty of little cheddar bunnies. He ate half of those. He ate most of his bread, and then he didn't really touch his grapes, which is really shocking, and then he did eat the pouch. So overall, I'm happy with it. And then my two-year-olds, only a little bit of the cheddar bunnies. She ate all the grapes. She ate all the dried fruit, a little bit of the cucumbers, only a couple of the carrots, and all the turkey and all the cheese, and there's a little bit of regurgitated turkey. Always a little bit of regurgitation with my daughter, to be expected. Overall, I'd say this was a mom win day. Thank you guys so much for watching this entire video of What's Packin'. Hope you guys catch the next installment of What's Packin'. I'm having so much fun making these videos. So there are gonna be more of these videos. If you like them, again, make sure you subscribe to my channel to find more healthy lunchbox videos and all things hashtag mom life. We got some homeschool in there. We got some mom stuff in there. We got some kids acting like crazy fools in there. Everything's in there. Everything's in my channel. Thanks again, guys. Hope you have a great week. Until the next time. Berkeley, do you like your lunch today?
Yes, because I put out my hand and because I too much in my mouth.
Week two of What's Packin' starts now. Week two of what's happening? That's not happening. Stick around if you're new here. Should stop winking. Oh dang, you can see my sports bra. I mean, I wear real bras all the time.
Never.
Welcome to week two of What's Packin'. Probably shouldn't. What's Packin'? Mama pulled something, I think. Jump around.